The topic is finding an x value given a percentile. So this problem is kind of like going backwards. It's kind of like you have the percentage, and then you need to find the z value, and then you find the x value. So we're going backwards. So let's do this example. Based on the model, the normal model with the mean, right, this is the mean, with the mean 1,152 pounds, and the standard deviation 84 pounds, describing Angus steer weights, what are the cutoff values for the highest 10%? The highest 10%, so assume this is the x we're looking for, and this area is 10%. 10% means 0.10 on the table, right, of the weight. So in other words, we want to know the highest 10% of steer weight will be are expected to be above what value, right? So this is the value that we're looking for, this x. So of course, the first thing we need to do is find the z value from the table. But this time we're going backwards. So we need to look for also the table only gave us, see, this is 10% and this is 90%, right? Which means 0.90, this area. So when we look at the table, we always get the area on the left of the z. So basically, let me put the z here. So this is a z value. This is what I'm looking for on the table, and this is 90%, which means 0.90. So if you go to the table, to the normal table, this time you're gonna go backwards. So you're gonna look at the middle of the page, and this is where z is gonna be positive, because we know it's 90 percentile, so it's above the mean. So what you do, you look, if you keep looking, you're gonna find the closest one will be 0.90%, will be 0.8997, right? And then if you keep going to the z value, you're gonna find 1.2. This is a z value. It starts 0.0, keeps going all the way to 1.2, and if you look here, you're gonna find 0.08. Therefore, z is equal 1.28. That's how you find a z. So this is 1.28. Once I find the z, the next thing I need to find the x value. So how do I find the x value? We know that z is equal x value, what we're looking for, minus the mean, which is 1152, divided by the standard deviation. So therefore, x minus 1152 is equal, multiply 84 by 1.28, you'll get 107.52, and then add 1152, and you'll get x equal 1259.52 pounds. Right, so this x is 1259.52. So the answer here will be the highest 10%. The highest 10% of steer weights are expected to be above 1259.52 pounds. Now let's do the next problem. Next problem, we have the lowest 20%, same way. We know less, lowest 20%, the z will be negative. But anyway, we're looking for this x, right? And this is 20%. So again, we're gonna go to the z value. We don't know what the z value, but we know this is 20%, which is 0.20. Same way, I'm gonna go look for the table. The closest one I'm gonna find will be 0.2005. If you look in the middle of the page, right on the left side where the z are negative, because we know 20% is on the left of the mean, so z is going to be negative. Now, you keep going all the way to the z. Remember now, the z is going to be on the right side. This is going to be negative 0.8, right? And it starts from negative 3.8, keeps going all the way here. Now, I need to find this number, which is 0.04. So therefore, by looking at this, I know my z is negative 0.84, right? This 4 comes from here. Right, now once I find the z, it's a negative 0.84, then I need to find my x. I know the z value is always going to be x minus the mean, which is 1152, divided by the standard deviation. Right, so we know how to find x this time, and x is going to be equal to multiply 84 by negative 0.84, then add 1152. It should give you 1111.68 pounds. So the answer here will be 20% of the weights of steers are expected to be below 1111.68 pounds. Now for next problem, we need to do the middle 40% of the weight. So we need to find the x values. So what do we mean with the middle 40%? This is what we're looking for. Now we're looking for two x's. This x and this x. Well, actually, both of them probably be negative. No. No, actually, no, that's not true. So this is the 40%, right? So how much left for 100%? 60. So we know this is going to be 30% here. We know this is going to be 30%, right? So let's use the normal table to find z first. So this is z. Well, this is another z. We know this is 30%, which is 0.30. And well, it's the same thing. We can find to find this z, we need to look for 0.30 and work backwards, right? And then to look for this z, by the way, it's 70th percentile. Let me write it down. This is going to be the 30th percentile, right? Because we always look at what's on the left of z, and this is going to be the 70th percentile. But of course, we don't want to look for both of them. There's a trick here. If you want to do shortcuts, you only need to find one, and we know they are going to be opposite. So let's just look for the 30th percentile, or for the if you look for this z, the 30th percentile, you're gonna find that z is actually equal to negative 0.525. So you can look for this 0.70. You don't have to, but if you do, you're supposed to get 0.525. So we know this is 0.525 with negative, and this is 0.525, right? So what's the next thing? We need to find both x's. This is what we're looking for. Once we find these x's, we're done. So if a z is equal negative 0.525, this is equal x minus The mean is 1152, forward standard deviation 84. Now, if we solve for x, x is supposed to be equal to 1107.9, 1107.9. And then if z is equal to 0.525, that's equal x minus 1152 over standard deviation. And in this case, the x, if you solve for x, you're supposed to get 1196.1. Right? So the middle, so therefore the answer will be the middle 40% of steer weights are expected to be between this value 1100.9 pounds and 1196.1 pounds. And that's it for this example.